Good morning. Our entrance is number 308.
The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise, lifting our voices, lifting our hearts to the glory of God forever. God of power and might, come into our presence this day. Strengthen us now with the spirit of faith we gather in your name.
The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise, lifting our voices, lifting our hearts to the glory of God forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. We come before the God of all grace, mindful of our sins, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I have written briefly about earlier. When you read this, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which was not made known to human beings in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this, I became a minister by the gift of God's grace that was granted to me in accord with the exercise of his power. To me, the very least of all the holy ones, this grace was given, to preach to the Gentiles the inscrutable riches of Christ, and to bring to light for all what is the plan of the mystery, hidden from ages past in God, who created all things, so that the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known through the church to the principalities and authorities in the heavens. This was according to the central purpose that he accomplished in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness of speech and confidence of access through faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. God indeed is my Savior. I am confident Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the rivers of salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim his name. Among the nations make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted his name. Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
That there are days understandably, in some respects, because life is busy. But the things of salvation should never be put off. You know, if there's a nice sort of this, and I really should reach out to them, well, then that really needs to happen. I should have really made amends, but that needs to happen. I really should have said something when they brought that up about what I believe, but well, that needs to happen. There's many I should have in the world of salvation. Jesus every day gives us a new chance to eliminate that phrase from our vocabulary and to act on the purpose that he has given to us, to proclaim the gospel and to bring him to others. So maybe an exercise for all of us would be, at the end of the day, run back how many I should have said, and then look at that a week later and see what we can do to improve what it is that God calls us to do this day. With our voices together, let us turn to God in prayer.
For church leaders and all who faithfully serve, may God bless them with strength as they lead the flock entrusted to them by God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For policymakers, may God's guidance inspire in them a renewed commitment to the value of human life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer physically or emotionally, may Jesus bring them comfort and assure them of his love, especially Bob Breyer, Donna Bueller, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Doug Fox, Dacia Furtney, Dave Gilbride, June Grismer, Julianne Jenkins, Deborah Kelly, Greta Krukmeyer, Tom Workowski, Bernie Mosioski, William Mason, Francis O'Leary, Marianne Oliver, Chloe Pasco, Nina Williams, Ann Richards, Vivianne Richardson, George Serva Jr., Courtney Shim, J.B. Zoller, and for the victims and survivors of abuse in our church and beyond, for accountability, justice, and healing throughout our church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this gathering of faith, may the Holy Spirit guide us as we work together to make our community a welcoming and loving place. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, for those who have recently died, Beth Cottrell, and for Angelo Janella, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they be welcomed into the joy of the heavenly banquet. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs written in our prayer notes book, along with those that remain in the silence of our hearts and minds, as well as those we have been asked to pray for. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear us as we pray in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received bread and offering. Fruit of the earth and work of your hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we can receive the wine of the offering, fruit of the vine, and work of your hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, my Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifices with the grace of the Holy Spirit, for our good and good of all His holy churches.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant they offer us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praise added nothing to your greatness, brought to us for salvation through Christ our Lord. So, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you can help us grow to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her into the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by the right teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Look toward the Lord and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed.
Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Spirit